Good morning, friends. After the learning of the and understanding of the syllabus, what is the syllabus of your semester 5th, we are going to turn towards our module 1st, part A, interview skills. Today we are going to learn what are the various necessary parts for interview skills. First part, introduction from your book, that is interview skills. That, dear students, in BA part 3, you studied interviewing famous person. BA part 2, you studied interviewing famous personalities in unit 1st, module 1st. It is formal interview. It is a conversation in which a reporter elicits information from a famous person. You have probably seen and heard such interviews of eminent people on television, radio, and also on YouTube. They are generally leaders, politicians, film stars, sportspersons, writers, and industrialists. In this module, we are going to learn skills of how to give job interviews. Interview skills are indispensable for job seekers. A job interview is an interview in which a conversation occurs between an employer and a job applicant. Many a times, a job applicant with all necessary qualifications and good academic records fails to perform well at the time of interview. As a result, he or she becomes unsuccessful in getting the job. So it is essential to acquire interview skills. At the time of interview, the employer evaluates whether the applicant is suitable for the job or not. He or she judges candidate's knowledge, aptitude, sense of values, and attitude towards work. Thus, a job interview gives an opportunity to the job seeker to present his or her capabilities before the interviewers. Anyone seeking employment nowadays realizes that the nature of job interviews has changed drastically. It is not the same as it was 10 years ago. Today, certain factors have affected the nature of work. Globalization, advanced technology, information overloaded, growing diversity, and teamwork-based organizations. The candidate must be well equipped to face these circumstances. The present module is introduced to you by keeping the current scenario in mind so that after the completion of your degree, you will be able to face job interviews. This is about the introductory part, that is, what are the most important part in interview skills, as there is necessity of your previous knowledge as well, and in future you are going to learn various interview skills. The next part, the first part, preparation for interview. The first and foremost thing required is preparation for the interview to get the positive result. As soon as you receive the letter for the interview, you should start preparing yourself for the interview. Remember the following points. What are the following points? First, read the interview letter carefully. Know the details, exactly day, date, time, and venue of the interview, so that you can understand, you can reach at the place of interview on correct time. Next, prepare your resume carefully and impressively with all the details of your qualifications, documents, references, etc. Do not forget to carry additional copies of your resume with you. So here you have to be particular for your documentation. Next, if you are instructed to bring the original certificates and other testimonials, arrange them in a proper order. The latest certificate on the top and the earliest certificate at the bottom, in a decent folder or a file. All the certificates should be attached serially. The required documents are resume, that is curricular vitae, interview call letter, degree certificates, mark list, NSS NCC sports certificates, experience certificates, references, etc. Next part, most important, that is, wear formal clothes for good impression. Clean, well-pressed clothes imply that you are taking the interview and also the job seriously. Avoid gaudy and fashionable clothes. Wear polished shoes with socks. Do sufficient homework to face interview questions. Visit the company organization's website and know about its vision, mission, structure, products, services, growth and finance. In case the company does not have a website, you may get information from other sources or you may call the Chamber of Commerce. Don't be surprised if one of the first questions interviewers would ask, have you gone through our website? Next important point is, collect adequate information about the nature of the job for which you have applied and revise it by collecting additional information and know the nature of the organization, whether a government office or a teaching institution or a private industry or a multinational company or a bank or LIC office in which you are presenting yourself as a candidate. So you must know what kind of job you are going to accept and what is your role for that particular job. Next, refresh your knowledge of the subjects of your specialization at graduation. It might be history, geography, English, sociology, economics, Hindi. So whatever your subject at your graduation and post-graduation level, you must know proper subject knowledge of your graduation. It is quite natural for interviewers to ask questions on the subject of your specialization. Refresh or revise your knowledge of the field, concepts, definitions, formulas, and theories, etc. If possible, give a mock interview in front of your close friends and well-wishers. This will boost your confidence and help you understand weaknesses. So, here are some points about preparation for interview. The last point is most important, mock interviews. Instead of it, you are going to face your interview without mock interview. It will be a very loose interview. Before going to interview, try to practice for that interview through mock interview. Next part is facing the interviewing strategies. See, these are the very simple things described and put it in your textbook. So go through those winning strategies for facing the interview. See, first most important winning strategy, walk in smartly and cheerfully from the entrance to the interview table. Don't forget to ask permission politely before entering. May I come in, sirs or madams? Greet the interviewers confidently. Good day, sirs or madams. Don't forget to seek permission to sit down. See, very simple things are the winning strategies. Next, maintain a cheerful disposition and a pleasant countenance in order to hold the interviewer's interest throughout the interview. A soft, pleasing expression with a smile enhances your personality. Display enthusiasm, self-confidence in whatever you say. Self-confidence generates self-esteem and self-respect. Be well-mannered. Your demeanor reflects your values and your culture. So be humble and polite throughout the interview. Use such expressions. Yes, please. I beg your pardon. Thank you. I wish to state, I would like to draw your kind attention to, etc. Next important winning strategy, maintain a moderate eye contact with members while they ask questions. Next, listen carefully at the time of interview. You must primarily focus on providing effective answers to interview questions. Listening is just as important as answering questions. If you do not pay attention, you will not be able to give best responses. A good listener is always a winner. Next important part, Modulate your voice so that your reply will be audible to every member of the interview panel. Answer the questions precisely and in brief. Long and winding explanation can only consume time and may bore the interviewers. Reveal team spirit, cooperation, organization skill, strength of character, and above all, a strong decision-making ability. Next, be alert and energetic throughout your interview. Show loyalty to your previous organization, though you may have left it due to unsavory circumstances. A common question asked by interviewers is, why did you leave your previous organization? You may give explanation such as your own career aspirations, long distance to work, aspiration for something more challenging, etc. Seek clarification to questions you do not understand. You can do it in a polite manner by asking, excuse me, pardon me sir, will you please repeat the question, etc. Next important point, report at the venue of the interview at least half an hour before the scheduled time of interview. It shows your punctuality. Be polite to everyone you meet both before and after the interview. So, those are the simple winning strategies stated here for your facing the interview. Next part, some do don'ts at the time of interview. You must remember those don'ts for your interview practice and for your actual interview. First, do not loll in your chair in a relaxed manner or lean back in the chair. Second, do not try to approach too close to the interviewers. Next, do not put your hands and fumble in your pocket. Never raise your voice or speak in a hushed tone. Do not rush to answer. Speak distinctly in your normal accent and pause to make your points effectively. Do not make any awkward movements, scratching head, ear or nose, moving hands awkwardly, putting hands or fingers in mouth, etc. Do not exaggerate about your hobbies or interests. The interviewers are intelligent people. Don't be overconfident. Don't be nervous if you don't know the answer of a question. Confess it frankly by saying, I'm afraid I haven't come across that piece of information, sir, etc. Do not ask about salary during an interview unless the interviewers ask about it. You may ask about salary range only after the interviewers ask you. So, here we can understand what are the don'ts at the time of interview. Again, never be offensive in your speech with the interviewers. Avoid negative talk and expressions. No, I am not. Haven't. I haven't. I don't. Or I didn't. Or I never. Etc. Do not say I dislike it. Instead say I like this less than others think. So you should not give negative expression at the time of interview. These are the three points. That is, first, preparation for interview. Second, facing an interview. That is, winning strategies. And third, some don'ts at the time of interview. In next part, we will learn the next part of our interview skills. Till then, thank you.